Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Medieval Engineers Planet. I'm the Radio Man 03 here at the Rising Sun Kingdom, and it is awesome to have you along. You see me up there? Thought that'd be a good place to start today, up on the tower. The Tower of Power in the Rising Sun Kingdom. Look at this. Look at this place. There's the walkway we just finished up. You can see I've got three braziers out there now, including a fourth. You can't really make it out from here, but it's just as you go up the stairs. It's lighting up the staircase up onto that walkway down there. There's the smithy shop down below there. I did a little change in that as well. Had some great suggestions come in about it. I left it pretty much the way it is because I want to move on, because Keen Software House, again, had another update. It's Tuesday. Another update, and they keep talking about the big major updates coming in just a couple of weeks. So, you know, we got that to think about. So I want to make sure I can finish this up. I've actually asked them, is this something that's going to make us start a new world? Because if that's the case, ladies and gentlemen, we've got to hustle. We have got to hustle and bustle and get some things done around here. I would love to be able to get the inside of this done. Even if we don't get the walls completed, I would like to get the structures done. Where am I and what am I doing? Here we go. Okay. I'm lost in my own keep. What are you doing? What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Let's go downstairs and take a look. And we'll take a look at what the update was today, too. Let's go take a look inside the blacksmithy shop. And voila. Tab, get our stuff back up. I put a wood floor in. I thought a wood floor would be far more appropriate. You'd be able to sweep and clean this out. One of you suggested the door being put, I believe, right here, so that when the smithy came in from outside, he wouldn't track dirt into his room. I don't know that the smithy's going to be too concerned about dirt in his room, to be quite honest with you. You know, it's a dirty job. It is a dirty job. Now, we could use some stuff on the shelves, but we're going to need some iron for that. Let me close that door up. We're going to need some iron and things like that, so we can put iron parts and things of that nature up on the shelves. To be seen and on the tables and stuff like that. So that's something I'm thinking about. It was also suggested we do a second floor and put the bedroom on the second floor. I kind of decided against that because I just don't feel like we've got enough room to really make the second floor look very good because it is such a small building. So we're going to leave everything downstairs here. But it's a nice room. I moved the bookshelf over so it's a little closer to the bed. It doesn't quite sit center on that wall there. So there was that. And then the other thing I noticed in the video from the last episode was that this shelf was hung over a little bit off. So I put that centered kind of like this one is. But it sits a little bit higher too. So it's a little higher. It's okay. That's fine. Shelves don't all have to be on the same playing field. You know what I'm saying? They can be a little bit swapped around here. Wow, those doors, man. There we go. So yeah, the big update is coming in a couple of weeks. Deep Flame said they're just doing some polishing on it, so it's going to be here. It's pretty exciting. Number one thing, the interface is going to be a lot easier. We're going to be able to alt-click, which was mentioned in their video today, which is going to be fantastic to get one item out of your inventory instead of having to take the whole stack or right-click and to punch in a number. You'd just be able to do that. These guys were added today. Look at these guys. They're amazing. This is the, what do you call this thing here? This is the stone stockpile. Just like the timber and the log one, this is a stone one. I put them in here, in where the mine is, and I filled them all up too. It took me about 15 to 20 minutes to fill them up. But I've got a ton of stone now sitting here, which is really awesome, I think. Just awesome. So yeah, I'm in love with these things here. Oh man, I got 30 of these on me. Oh, you know what? I cooked up a bunch of food. It's scattered about the kingdom so that wherever we are, we can grab some food. Something else happened today that was kind of interesting down here in the mine. Keep in mind that the mine does have an odd looking angle to it. It's just the nature of the beast here. But if you look over here, I was digging, and all of a sudden I started seeing some grass, and I punched a hole through almost, this is actually the foundation to where the king statue is sitting on, and the staircase that goes up to it. That's where this punches out to. So I'm not sure what I want to do with this. That could be kind of like our little secret door we've talked about. Now, it doesn't get us out of the kingdom, though. That's the thing. It doesn't do that. And the king would have to go out to the mine and everything to get to it. But we could put a door there and make another access to the mine itself from outside next to the staircase. I'll show you where it is. Let's go out there and take a look. We're going to work on something today, and I've got to send a thank you out to Nephum in the comments on the last episode. He sent me a information about a mod that I think I would like, and I do like it. There's a door mod. It's called HGY Ceilings, HGY Doors. Now, the ceiling is right here. Now, the doors, you know, I never did look for the doors yet, so I'm not quite sure where they're at. I'll have to take a look around in here and see if I can find where the door mod would be in here, unless it's something that just comes with this door here, like so. No, it doesn't look like it's there. Yeah, I'm not quite sure where it would be, but I'll look around for it. It's got to be in here somewhere. That's the stick fence. These guys are just... I love this addition right here. These guys have been really handy. You can go out and get a stockpile of material, pile it up, and then you can go to work for a while, which is really nice to do a little bit of grind and then do a little bit of build, a little bit of grind, and so on and so forth. It really turns out... It makes me a happy man. I'm not sure where the doors are on here. Oh, wait. Here we go. Oh. I don't see anything with the doors. There's the ceiling, but I don't see anything with the doors. I wonder if maybe the mod's not available right now. Oh, somebody else had a question too. What mods do I have on the game? Let's take a look at that real quick, and I'll show you what I've got on here. No, it's I gotta back out. I've gotta back out. I'll show you the mods that I'm playing with on the game right now and the mods that I have loaded up. So we do load world, edit settings, and down here you've got your mods. Right now, like the companion's hunting dog, I could not get that one to work, unfortunately. I would love to be able to have my rascal in here with me, but I can't. The armored mail, I took that off until we get an updated version of that, because remember it had the weird bobbing in the head of the character. Deco Pack 2. This is for, I believe... this is for just another mod for creative decoration. Well, let's go ahead and put that over there, and we'll see if we can actually use this one. But these are the ones I have. The lever jack, which is really handy in case your cart breaks down. You could pop one of these into the cart and lift the cart up and be able to put the wheel back on. That's a very handy mod. Additional blocks mod. That's the one a lot of you guys have asked me about. That's the extra 67 blocks. That's very nice. Containers and accessories. It's the little crates, the little boxes, the baskets, the vases and things like that. Integrated wooden gate. That's the gate we used on the gatehouse we built over by the bridge, that where we tore the warehouse down and put that one in. That one's very handy. And then I'd use the HGY functional doors. I'm not quite sure where that is. Maybe it doesn't work, but the ceiling does. And we're going to use that ceiling one today. Okay, there we go, and let's load the world back up. Lots of neat mods out there. There really is a lot of neat mods, and this next update is going to make it easier for modders as well as the developers, Keen Software House, to progress with the game, which is really great news. If you're not subscribed to him, you should be, so that you get the updates every Tuesday. Every Tuesday there is an update. This Tuesday was an addition, as well as some bug fixes. An additional block, which is that stone, the stone stockpile, that was added. And then they did some bug fixes, and of course they talked a little bit about what's coming up in the big update. All right, so we need some supplies. Let's get some supplies, guys. Let's go in here. Oh, we came back in, so I need to start this up again. I love having that little campfire going. And I put a couple of chairs there too, you know. A couple of lazy bums sit there and just watch the world go by while they're at the fire. Let's use up these guys first. And I did a little bit of stocking before I got on today. And we'll start with this back stone stockpile first. That is such a cool thing. They really are, those really look great. I really like them. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put another timber one down in this corner, and these chests I'm going to put up on this walkway up here, and I think that's going to work better. Things feel a little bit laggy to me all of a sudden. Windows 10 had a great big update, and I'm glad I checked, because you know what it did? It turned my microphone off on OBS, so I would have been here recording again and had nothing. No sound. That could be extremely frustrating. So anytime I get a big Windows update now, I check those things, because you just never know. I put one of these guys over here. Let's take a look at this. I'll show you how these blocks look. Beautiful. That's nice. Look at that. You see that guy right there? That's pretty dang nice. I'm going to leave the other stone pillars up there just for a little added flavor. These guys are expensive, huh? A little bit. And boom. Not too bad, though. Not bad at all. And then they've got this really nice, if you go number 5 and we scroll it, it's got this piece here, the ceiling straight. I'm so glad you turned me on to this mod because, yeah, this is one of those things that I would love to be able to do and have. So I could do that there, and I could do that there, and I don't think I can reach that, though. Hmm. Is that going to blend in all right there? Maybe it does. Let's finish putting it together. We need to do something to all blocks to decorate this place up. The front entrance. You guys have always said that. You get that front entrance decoed out, radio. It's like, okay, let's do it. Number 4. Tab. There we go. That was weird. Okay. Well, that doesn't exactly line up with that. You know what? Maybe I've got this sitting in here the wrong way. Let's try it the other way around and see if it looks better. Yeah, let's try it this way instead. Did I put it back in the same way? No, I didn't. Okay. Yeah, I did. I put it right back in the same way I had it before. This is the first time I'm playing with them, so I'm doing it with you guys just to kind of see how they go. Maybe I do need to remove these pillars. These guys right here. I'm just afraid something's going to come tumbling down on me, you know what I mean? You got to be really careful about this stuff. Like that. And number 5 again. I don't know if that looks right. Well, let's knock it all the way into place and see how it looks. This is a ceiling extension. HDY stone ceiling straight small parts. Is this supposed to go on the back side of this one here, I think, maybe? Is that why it looks so unusual? Because I was hoping it would kind of continue this curvature all the way across here. Let's put this other one in the other way. Nope. Like that. And we're going to need something else up here to get up and down. Okay, all of a sudden, I feel a bit laggy in here. I don't know that this is going to actually accomplish what I was hoping to accomplish here today. I may have to break away and take a look at it and see. Well, I'm standing in the way. That's something I'm also teaching myself, is that if a block does not place, odds are you might be standing in the way, so get out of the way. Get your feet out of the way. We've got some interesting curves and stuff going on there, but it's just not quite what I had in mind. It's really not. I have a feeling that, they're just not sitting in there the way I want them to be. I wanted this to continue across here, and we just have a nice, simple, extra little curvature here for the entranceway, and it's just not behaving the way I thought it was going to work out. when you tack them into place the other direction, they don't seem to line up much better, do they? Number five again. Yeah, it just kind of sits low, doesn't it? Let me tinker with this a little bit. See what I come up with. I'm going to take all these down and start over again. And then I'll come back. But yeah, I think I need to fiddle around with this a little bit more. I was doing a lot of grind at the beginning to get prepared for today's episode. So let me do that. Let me knock these out and I'll take a look at it and see what I come up with. So I'll be right back. All right, I was right. These guys look a little bit better. These side pieces coming off the back end of this. So I've got the two coming in. From side to side, I put the stone pillars down here to hold them up. And then we've got these guys, the other option on number five, these stone ceiling straight small parts on the edge, the back edge of it. And it seems to work out a little bit better this way. I was having some lag problems there. They seem to have cleared up a little bit. I have noticed that when I hit escape and hit save here, normally... Okay. Now it's not doing it. It was not giving me... It said the world was already saving. Error. So I'm not getting that message anymore. Now what I'm wondering here is... Can I bring... this out one more? I'd kind of like to do that. Hit Z to bring that up. And Z again to put it back here. And just to, I know you guys want it really grand, but I feel like I've gotten a little too far into it to be able to do as grand an entrance as I would probably like to do. Z again, and that's going to move your blocks around. But that should bring it out and make it look a little more substantial. Yeah, I think so. Let's go ahead and knock these into place and we'll see. It looks like we're going to have to go get some more stone here in just a second. We'll get this one put in and we'll go get some more stone. Let's knock this out of here. And we'll get this one out of here. Boom. Let's go on down. Let's take a look back and see what it looks like. It's definitely going to be more grand. I don't want to make the door entranceway, the door itself into the Great Hall any bigger for the sole fact that I feel like it would just let so much of the world inside. Before, remember, when we first started this, we didn't have any of this here. It was all wide open. And, you know, there were some comments about, wow, that's really letting a lot of the outside in. And it would be. It'd just be freezing cold in there. You could never get that thing warm. So, as it is, it would be difficult to keep it warm now. But, yeah, I think for what we've got going on in this season, we've got a pretty good go of it. Let's grab a few more sticks, too, while we're at it. There we go. Might as well have a few more sticks, and then we'll see what else we can get ourselves mixed up in. But I really feel like that might be the last piece of the keep that we've been working to get to. And now it's going to be more substantial. We're going to come up, and we're going to have this little corner to go around and stuff to get in. I think it might be what we're looking for. It's not as fancy as it probably could be, but it's fancier. It's not just a flat wall with a small door in it. We've got some big arches now leading to it, so I think that's going to help out considerably. With the way it looks, to make it look a little more keep-like and entrance to Great Hall. And did I get this one already? I did. All right, so now we're going to grab these big guys up here. Let's knock these boys into place. And yeah. I like them. I do like these. And I like the way they build together, too. It's almost like... I think that was the older way that it used to work on Medieval Engineers, right? The way these things go together. They don't look... Like right there, you can see the curvature and stuff. Like, someone's actually working on it and building it up and stuff. And they're having to continuously add more stone and more stone and more stone to it. That's not too shabby. Let's go down here. Let's look through the front door. It gives it more pizzazz, don't you think? I mean, we could continue it out over on this side here too, but then we got to bring up the wall, and then I lose my wooden staircase and railing, and I don't want to lose those things. I like those things there. They add to it. So now we come up, we come in, and you come out. You've got this overhang. I think that's better. I think it's better. Is it as great as it could be? No, but remember, I'm relatively new at the game. You know, this is our first big projects. These are our first big projects we've been doing. So with each thing we put together, we learn more and more about the game and what we can and can't do with it. So I think it's very exciting. I really enjoy that aspect of the game. But I think that's much better. It gives it a little something extra to it when you walk up to it. Yeah, I would say so. I'm pretty happy with that and how it looks. I am. Come into the Great Hall. And boom. I think some of you would like to see the double wood door here. But look, I mean, we've got this arch here. And we've got these organized so that they're even. And it just... Yeah, I don't want to mess it all up. I do not want to mess it all up. I like it. It's good. I think we're good. Yeah. Yeah, that's good. That's good. All right, super. Fantastic. All right, now what kind of other projects we're getting? You know what? Let's I know what we need to do. We need to go out and discuss what's going on out at the mine. Ooh, got a long ways away. Oh, other thing I wanted to talk about to you guys about. There have been some really great ideas for this space right here, this big divot that's right here. Now remember, our road is going to travel up this way. And really, we're going to have room for a road and maybe something very small up here. But the road goes up this way and goes up. That's the hillside where the church sits up there. This down here, and then the road is also going to come down from this area right here. And it's going to turn and probably cut... Well, it's probably going to go right along this edge right here. It'll probably turn right here and come along here and come straight down. The idea for this spot, I've had two really good ideas. One is a downstairs tavern with an upstairs inn. So it would be a two-story structure here. The bottom part, of course, would be nestled down inside this divot here. And then the top part would be up here. It'd be a sizable building, but it would be an inn upstairs and then a tavern downstairs. So you'd be able to enter the tavern from, say, right here. You go through a door and you're inside the tavern. And then you could, from the road, you'd be able to go in the upstairs area and enter the inn. And there's probably going to be a staircase downstairs in the bottom of the tavern that would go up. We may wind up not being able to have a road come through this direction here. If we could terraform and stuff, odds are, yeah, we could do a road. But we can't terraform, really. So there's that issue. Yeah. Other thing I wanted to take you guys out to is where we've been getting our... We gotta be really careful too. We have barbarians in the broad daylight attacking. I almost died today while I was out here getting trees. He had an axe. He hit me 3 times with it and it just about killed me. But the good news, I've still not had any barbarians within the castle walls. So I think we found all the spots where they were getting through. I hear you. That one had antlers, didn't he? He was definitely an antler carrying deer. Nothing planted right now. But let's head on out to where we've got the mine right now. I mentioned last episode that we were running low on iron. It is fading away. And we're almost done with that. And there was a suggestion that... what I was thinking about doing was I would take the palisades, I would take everything that's there, and I would move it to a new location. And the idea was, is why not leave it there and make it look like just this little barbarian fort that's sitting out there that maybe they live in a little bit, and we could just leave the walls up and just leave it there and move on to our next spot, just so there's other little structures sitting around out here. But yeah, that's a great use of the imagination right there. So I'm good with that. But let's see what the next iron deposit's going to be that we're going to go after. There's just so much food laying around here. Look at all this wheat. There's tons of wheat. So this is where I've been coming for the iron. I don't know if you guys know that, but we've got a little bit of a palisade structure going on out here. And every time I come out here, I am attacked by barbarians. At least the wall of the palisade is. Sip my coffee there real fast. They like to come and attack the palisade wall. What's going on here? What are you guys doing down on the ground? Oop, nope, V. I can't pick that up. How much damage are we talking about here? Get this tree out of the way. Nothing. Why are there timbers laying on the ground here? God, what did they break inside? I can't pick that timber up either. It's okay laying there. It's no big deal. I'm just trying to figure out what it is they damaged. It's not something that I spent a whole lot of time putting up. It was just really a wall just to keep them out. I think I can actually jump it. Yeah, I can. They can't, but I can. So there's a bunch of stone out here, but this is where I've been coming to get the iron right now. These chests are all filled with stone right now. And you can see, although it looks like there is a lot here, there is not a lot here anymore. It's just about gone. We got one there. Yeah, my inventory's full. But yeah, it's. I think we've got a little bit right here. I think this last row right here, this is not iron anymore. It looks like there is here, but there is no iron here. There's no iron back here, despite the fact we see the colors and stuff here. This is all gone back in here. So I think I've got what it is a little bit right up in here, and then a little bit right down here. So we've got to move this thing. And I thought since I've got you here today, it's my shorter time to record today, we would take a look and see. Come on, out you go. All right. There we go. Beautiful. Out. There we go. Let's throw some of this stone in. And we'll throw the iron in the furnace up here. This is it, though, for this chunk. So we're out of iron here. There are other iron deposits nearby. Let's go on out and we'll take a look around and see. I believe there's one back behind here a little bit that we could easily get to next. The easiest way I've found to find things in the ground, especially if you're foraging, is to go to B, hold your Alt button down, scroll back a little bit, and you get a good look at the ground around you. Now, you can see we've got another iron deposit right over here. We could move and build another little thing right over here, almost like it's a dual encampment, but we have an iron deposit right here we could dig up. I've not really gone up on this side to see if there's any more. I'm trying to stay kind of close to home. We've never been up this way. Let's take a little stroll and see what's going on. There's one up there too. Up on that hillside. I might be crazy, but it seemed like some extra ones were added into the game. Maybe, maybe not. Not enough stamina. The kingdom looks really awesome back there. I don't see anything up on that hill that's worth looking at. Okay, from up here you can see we've got a deposit right there. We have another one right there. And, wait, is that where we are? I can't tell if that's where we're digging. No, there's the palisades right there. So, okay. Where did it go? We'll go to that one right there. It looked really dark. Yeah, it's right down here. Okay, perfect. The kingdom is massive off in the distance. I think that might be the one we were just looking at, huh? I heard something. No. So, okay, we've got the yellow patch there. And we have another one right over here, too. So this one looks really tiny. This could all be iron, but odds are that it's not going to be the entire area filled with iron. So I think the next one we go to is going to be this one here. But like I said, I think there... Who knows? We'll have to find out if the big update coming is going to have to make us... you know, swap out and start a new world. I don't know. I'm hoping not, because I would like to finish what we've started here. But if need be, no big deal. We can do that. I think we've done really, really well on the Rising Sun Kingdom. It looks pretty dang impressive, I think, from a distance. I love it. I've had a lot of fun putting it together, and we'll do another season for sure. Yeah. But yeah, check her out in the distance there. Looks very nice. There are no iron deposits in this forest right next to us, unfortunately. Otherwise, I would put something up in there, but we will. I will go ahead and get something set up out there with some palisades. Maybe we'll do an episode of that together, just kind of set up an iron mine that we can get more iron with. Any other ideas for buildings inside? I think we've had some in the past. You guys have come up with some great ideas. I'm coming through, dear. Coming through. Look out. Run. Run. Look at all the deer. Holy cow. A lot of deer. We have like 4 stacks of meat. We're good on meat right now. And the veranda looks nice up there. I don't think we ever came out here to check out the veranda from outside the walls here. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Those are wispy clouds going by up here in the sky. That's pretty awesome. Yeah, that looks pretty darn good. That chandelier. Man, I love that chandelier idea. That is awesome. Very good ideas. Tell you what, I got some pretty creative subscribers. You guys have got some really great information you pass on to me. I appreciate it so much, too. It's really fantastic. Yeah, the support for the series has been tremendous as well. Come on. There you go. Down you go. Beautiful. All right. Turn that off. I was going to show you the hole in the ground. This is where the hole pops out right here. So it would not be too difficult. See the vine down there? You can see it. It wouldn't be too difficult to put a door right here. We'd be able to go inside the door and go right underneath and get into the mine this way. That's a possibility. If you guys got ideas for that little hole in the ground there, let me know. We can make it a little bit bigger if we need to. Otherwise, I think that is going to wrap up today's episode, I do believe. So, the keep, construction-wise, I believe I'm done. Let me know if I'm not, if there was something else we were going to do to it, but I believe the grand entrance was the last piece that needed to be taken care of. And we've got that now. We've got that with this right here. I believe this is what we were looking for. Mm-hmm. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed the episode today. I really do. Thank you so much again for your support. I appreciate it very, very much. If you enjoyed today's episode, hit that like button for me. I'd appreciate it very much. It helps tremendously. Comment, subscribe, and share. I'm the Radio Man 03. Have an awesome, fantastic, and superb day, and I look forward to talking to you again next time.